Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meakin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do a ripped, distressed denim design in gel polish. Now this is easy for you guys who love to create artwork with gel polish. Let's get ripping that denim. I've already created a nail using warm beige from the Naio Nails acrylic range, obviously. I am going to use a selection of beautiful, look at them, that's quite good for beatboxing. In this selection of colours we have Snow White, and we have this gorgeous faux fur effect morning chill. It's very chilly at the minute, actually. And then we have this colour, which is a pale blue, and we have this sort of medium blue, I would say that is. It's definitely blue, and we've got a darker blue. I'm going to take some backing paper from Sculpting Form. I am going to put a little bit of each of the blues. Then with the faux fur, we're going to mix some faux fur into a
faux fur. It sounds like a mistake, doesn't it?
Yeah. So we're mixing the faux fur into the colour. And you can actually see the fibres in there. How cool is that? Guess whose idea this was?
Whose?
Adam the cameraman's idea. How cool is Adam? He loves nails. He's really ruining his street cred. So I've mixed those in. I'm going to work straight onto this nail. Doesn't need a base coat because it's on top of acrylic. So if you're doing it on a natural nail, you would need to apply the base coat. So first of all, I'm going to start with this medium blue. And I'm going to add a little bit of the paler blue. And a bit of the darker blue, just so we get a few different shades. So it looks a little bit more stonewashed. It'll help it look more textured as well, if it has a slight difference in colour. Before we cure this, we're going to take away some of it to create the opening for the rip. And all I'm doing is dipping my brush into the gel residue wipe off solution and then just dragging through. I am taking the excess off the brush and then I'm just dragging through to create that opening. And we're going to pop that into the lamp. I'm going to get the lighter colour now. And just add a little bit of that around the edge of the tear. It does not need to be super neat. And pop that in the lamp. So you can see by adding the faux fur to your colours, you get those little fibres, which makes the denim look really realistic. It's a pretty cool effect. It's going to make it look like proper denim. Real McCoy. What I'm going to do now is wipe over with the gel residue wipe off solution. And all I'm doing is taking off a sticky layer because we're going to do a little bit of artwork on here. And I can't work directly on top of that sticky layer. Not with acrylic paints, it will really interfere with it and make it go a bit gloopy. And we don't want that. So I'm going to do a little bit of fishnet in there because it's really fashionable at the minute to wear fishnets under your ripped jeans. So we're going to do that. So we're going to use black acrylic paint. This is the polycolour paint. I'm going to water it down a little bit just so it flows. The paint will continue to dry, so you will need to keep adding a little bit of water to it. So I'm just going to paint the fishnet in. So we're just going to do lines first of all. Then we're going to cross over. Then each of these sections, you're going to slightly soften the... So you're giving that triangle. It's not a triangle, oh my God, what's wrong with me? I did go to school. Not all the time. But I did. Yes, these are diamond shapes. So these diamond shapes, we're going to soften each of the corners off. Again, this doesn't need to be absolutely perfect. Because if you notice the texture of fishnets, each hole isn't completely perfect. They're all quite unique. I'm going to make a wash now with the black paint. So water it down to make a wash so it's more transparent. Then add a little bit of shading around the outside so it makes it look like it is actually underneath the denim. Then we're going to use titanium white poly colour acrylic paint. So what I'm going to do now is add the little bit. I'm going to add little details of the fibres from where it's been ripped. And again, these do not need to be perfect. They need to be little random little strands. Just added a few little lines just to make it look more distressed. And then what we're going to do is add the little fibres that will come across. Before I finish this, I am going to apply the top coat, but we're going to use matte top coat. I like a bit of matte top coat because it makes it look a little bit more realistic, because obviously you don't get shiny denim jeans. Or maybe that should be a thing.
I had a pair of shiny denim jeans years ago.
Like a lacquer on them. A bit leatherette.
You know when... Double denim came into fashion, like, but like twisted denim.
Yeah.
I had some like twisted denim, yeah. And it was shiny, it had a gloss to it.
Oh. I'm going to wipe over with the gel residue wipe off solution. You have to take the sticky layer off the top coat, the matte top coat, that is. I think that looks so cool. I absolutely love it. But a bit of bling wouldn't go amiss. Let's add a bit of bling. I'm going to use some mega gloss just here. And I'll sit the stones directly onto that. And they'll just sink into the mega gloss like that. And the mega gloss will just hold that on. Because it's thicker mega glosses than the Urban Graffiti top coat, it will hold stones on a lot better. I'm going to pop that into the lamp. I'm going to finish off with some cuticle oil. Now, when you drag cuticle oil over the top of this design, it will have a sheen, shine to it. So I am going to wipe off the excess oil. You can use a bit of the gel residue solution just to take off your oil as well, just to bring it back to that matte finish. I love that. I want some of those. Can you do me some?
Yes.
Come on then.
I told you I'll cut up some jeans and I'll just encapsulate the jeans. You'll have nails that
are this time. I know, yeah, thick. Till I'm a nail, fill all my heart. I love it, love it, love it. Love it. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that video. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And I have Snapchat. Please check me out. I love hearing from you. I do try to reply to all my Snapchats. My Snapchat name is not my Snapchat name is. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed that. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram and my Snapchat, which is Kirsty Nails. I do try my best to reply to everybody on there. I love hearing what you've got to say. Do you know what? I have lots of people sending me pictures of their dogs and things like that. random pictures of themselves. But it makes me laugh. It makes me giggle. So guess what, guys? I will see you in the next video. Ta-da! Ah, 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 ah.